If the first album was intellectualizing everything, then perhaps this album is about feelings.
I saw you cry today. Saw you shy away. The pain will not kill you. You made me smile today. You spoke with many voices.
I know what she did with 07, but I don't know of her solo projects prior to this. It would seem it was maybe a little more R&B than it is now, but she still has that kind of inflection in her voice. But she's definitely made it her own. And now sitting with this more organic type of music, it's quite original, I would say.
The reason I ended up making an R&B album before was because where I was from in Adelaide, the coolest and most fun people to hang around were hip-hoppers. And this time I was just on tour with 07 listening to all sorts of different music, and I decided I liked that and I wanted to make stuff that was like that. I just wanted to make music that was played by real people.
It's from the heart, from her perspective, and in a way the songs are sort of built around that. Yeah, I don't think she's too concerned about image or any of that kind of stuff. It's more about the music.
We're in Rye and we're at a studio called Heliocentric. It's just extraordinary. It's beautiful. It's got marimbas that are just sound amazing. Usually what happens with pop music these days is that it's recorded digitally, and it's amazing. It's amazing technology, but it's lost some of the depth of the sound. And so I just wanted to make this kind of warm, real, kind of live sounding, atmospheric kind of album that sounds like it's old. That sounds like the old records, like, that I really, really loved.
Recording to tape has an more individual, kind of saturated, fat, whatever you want to call it, sound, than just going straight to zeros and ones. Computers are great, but they're really great when you use them in conjunction with the old stuff.
She'd instantly have ideas for not just sort of vocal melodies and lyrics, but just like lots and lots of sort of melodic ideas musically, like, you know, other instruments. And so we'd experiment with guitars, and she was playing a bit of melodica and messing around with all sorts of bits. And a lot of that actually ended up on the demos as well.
Will you show him your stuff on the stick, Kev? This is why I really wanted Kevin to be involved. It was the sock on the stick that did it for me. Check it out. He didn't skimp either. Because you can see he's got kind of a cheap sock under there. But on the outside, he's really come home. What's this called again? The Pringles kind of style of...
Pringles.
He's gifted in the art of just playing stuff. He plays those shampoo and conditioner holders that you hang off your shower thing, and he plays an upside down zither on a djembe.
Makes an alright sound.
I think I might need to have a little bit more guitar in my headphones as well.
For those who slept, for those who kept themselves jacked up.
So I know putting in Jesus wept kind of has given some religious connotations and the fact that it's about Sunday, but really it's not about the day of rest essentially, because Sunday for most people is just the day after Saturday.
Everything was totally about melody and trying to create a certain feeling, like have some sort of sentiment behind it, and just trying to make things which are sort of evokeful.
Yeah, it will be okay.
There's a great importance in feeling all of the uncomfortable stuff and trying to get it out. It was just about the day after having a big one, maybe feeling bad, pulling up your socks, forgiving yourself, moving on.
Once we're playing in a band and doing all that stuff, we had a nice couple of weeks of rehearsing and getting to know each other musically as well as personally.
Can you just help me to know what's the best way? How it sounds nicest?
Yeah, that's why I'm in here this time.
Cool. Because I'm thinking too much about it.
Yeah. Wicked, man.
We've got it.
It's all good. Yeah. There's a couple of those ones that were good, matched with a couple of elastics that are good. So, but we're gonna throw that into Pro Tools now from tape and put the drum track together.
Yeah.
And then vibe on, put all our start brainstorming our little other ideas of what we're talking about. Wicked, well done. Sounds great. Really, really nice.
I hadn't done drugs for a period of time before I wrote that song. It was about having a really horrible come down off ecstasy. And the concept of like it being over or being abandoned before you get to sleep, that sort of thing. Being the last one high. Everyone else has gone to bed. That's the incentive for that song.
We've just always had that connection, like that just undercurrent of stupidity, I think. It's like, I don't know, we've just always, I just been part of our friendship and relationship.
So don't let anybody else hear you. Secret business.
Sam really understands me.
Okay, hang on a minute.
Cool. We'll go for some tapes tomorrow then.
Breathe Me is about feeling worried, generally anxious, being overwhelmed by your own inner dialogue, and having some sort of conniption fit, and then potentially doing yourself some harm, and then asking for help.
Help, I have done it again. I have been here many times before. Hurt myself again today, and the worst part is there's no one else to blame.
This album is much more me than the last album necessarily, although the last album was me then, but this is me now. People ask me what it is, and I sort of go, songy. I've been telling people it's easy listening. I'm not sure if it is, but I think it is. I've been telling people it's easy listening, and they're like, what, we hear it on Magic? And I was like, hope so. That's like my fantasy.
Ouch, I have lost.